Hey guys, I'm Alex, and this is Jamee. We're here to talk about the Alliance Station and first power-up. The Alliance Station is 22 feet wide by 10 feet deep. It's sandwiched between the opposite Alliance's portals. In the back of the Alliance Station is the vault.
The exchange is in between Driver Station 1 and 2. Check out Kate and Malcolm's video on the exchange and the portals for more information. Thanks, Jamee, but this is the wrong video for that.
It's never the wrong time for that noise.
Back to the Alliance Station. Each station has a shelf for an operator console. Note the strip of 2-inch wide hook and loop tape, loop side up. Each station has an Ethernet cable which connects the operator console's computer to the field management system. The e-stop button on the shelf lets you disable your robot if necessary. There's an AC outlet for your operator console with a 2-amp fuse. If you find yourself in the middle player station, watch out for the equipment under the shelf.
Notice the stack lights above each player station. They relay important information to the field crew for quick diagnostics. The bottom amber light indicates that your robot has been e-stopped. The top two lights match your Alliance color. If they're off, it means it's before the match and the robot is linked, but disabled because the match hasn't started yet. If the lights are flashing slowly before the match once per second, it means that your robot has not yet linked to your driver station. If your robot loses connectivity with the driver station during the match, the lights will begin to flash again until connectivity is reestablished. If they're on, the robot is connected and enabled, but you only see this state during a match.
Hey, Jamee, check this out. This looks cool.
Alex, that's in Danny and Amanda's video about the vault and power-ups. Not this one. This one is about the Alliance Station.
Oh, man, they're so lucky.
Anyway, each player station has a team sign that displays their team number throughout the match. The official time remaining in the match is displayed on signs hung from the portal closest to Station 1. They're identified with a white strip of tape.
The starting line is 2.5 feet away from the Alliance wall. Drive teams must stay behind it during auto. Visibility around the scale will be a trick this year. Be sure to check the rules about protected zones.
Good luck!
And we'll see you at the competitions.